Tell me about your call.
My call was rather interesting because as I said earlier, I actually started speaking in church when I was about 18 years old. We had a Youth Day celebration, and that particular Sunday, I was given the assignment of extending the welcome and the occasion. And so I wrote a speech, you know. And the speech turned into a little sermonette. So, you know how we do it, Baptist preachers. Yeah. And so my pastor said, next year, you will be the Youth Day speaker. Wow. And Carla, his daughter, you will speak in the evening, Carla will speak in the morning. And so, you know, a year passed, and that's exactly what happened. From that, members of our church started talking to their friends, saying, there's this young girl that goes to our church, and she's not a preacher, but she speaks like a preacher. Mm-hmm. And so people started inviting me to speak at different churches. Wow. And from that, I started, you know, doing women days, youth days. I was, in those days, mistresses of ceremonies were really, really, really popular.
Right. That's right.
And so I spent a season also narrating for a community choir, the Angelic Voices of Faith. And actually, when I would narrate for them, I was doing many sermons too.
Right, right.
And my pastor would always say to me, you know, when are you coming to talk to me about about preaching?
Right.
And of course, there were really no models in terms of women preachers in terms of my experience and my upbringing. But thankfully, I had a pastor who believed that God could use women. Mm-hmm. And so he never had any issues or objections to even the thought of being called. In fact, he would bring it up more than I would. And he would always say, whenever you get ready, just let me know. Mm-hmm. And so finally, in 1989, I believe I really initially heard a call as we experienced it in 1986. Mm-hmm. I was leaving my parents' house, and I know that it was the voice of God. Mm-hmm. It was a heart impression, but it was a voice of God that was so strong that I began to cry. Mm-hmm. And I sensed God calling me into the ministry. But the fear of it, and as well as my desire and my fear of never getting married, because I was thinking, if I accept a call to ministry, I'll never get a husband. Mm-hmm. And so I was like, okay, we're going to negotiate this, right? Let's negotiate this, God. I'm going to do this, and I'll speak, but I won't accept a call to ministry. And so I pushed it out of my mind for about 3 years. But in the year of 1989, from January until December, there was this persistence that I could not shake. You know, I didn't see a light, I didn't see a burning bush, I didn't see myself standing before crowds speaking, but there was this nagging persistence that I could not shake. And so I committed it to prayer, and talked to my parents about it first, and then I talked to some of my friends, because you think about all of these things when you're really contemplating, at least I was, contemplating a call to preach. How will my friends act? You know, what will the members at the church say? How will I be received? What is this going to mean for my future as a female and all of this? Mm-hmm. And of course, the Lord won. Mm-hmm. And so the last Sunday in December of 1989, I went to service. I went to church before service started, and I told my pastor that I felt like I was being called to ministry. Mm-hmm. And he said, I was wondering what took you so long. And then he told me, he said, you'll never rest until you say yes.
Yeah, wow.
And so that was really the beginning of my journey officially with ministry. But 11 years prior to that, I had already been doing devotions, speaking in churches, narrating for concerts. Mm-hmm. So technically, I guess you could say I've really been preaching officially almost 30 years, mm-hmm. but unofficially maybe more like 41. Mm-hmm. All my life, pretty much.
Wow.